Hogan, and welcome to my vlog. I'm sorry, I couldn't resist. Alright, okay, so insane introductions aside, as you can see, we have a special little guest with us on today's vlog, which is, as I said last time, going to be another fanfluation vlog, or me talking about things that I'm into. Just to give you guys and myself a little bit of a break from multiverse lore, because that can get a bit heavy and a bit complicated, and yeah, sometimes I just need a break, and I suspect sometimes you guys will need a break. So I'm going to follow the same formula as last time and talk about one thing that has been with me since childhood. One thing that I have been really big into in the past but am not quite so big into now, and one thing that I am currently very into. So yeah, without any further ado, I think we will make a start, right? Yes, I'm insane. It's taking me this long to work out. Alright, so I will start fairly obviously with explaining why this guy is joining us today. This, for those of you who don't know, and I suspect that's probably a large number of you, because even some of my friends had never heard of this particular character prior to meeting me, which is disappointing, very disappointing. This is my old bear, and old bear is a character, a very real character, from Jane Hissey's Old Bear Stories series. As you can see, he is kind of my character. They look more alike when he was younger, I swear. So this is one of the first things, Old Bear Stories is one of the first things I remember ever being a fan of and being into, and it is something that to this day brings me happiness when I think about it. I still have my old VHS tapes somewhere, I'm not quite sure where, but they are definitely somewhere. I occasionally YouTube various episodes to watch, and it's really hard to find, but they are there. I still have the books that I had. Obviously I've just, you know, shown you one of them, and obviously I still have my old bear. And I think this is the reason why it probably had such a big influence on my life. As anybody's favourite bear would. I'm sorry, but if you're one of those people who are very sentimental when it comes to their childhood possessions and do still have one or two things around, you probably know what I'm talking about. And you know, this guy has been to university with me, he's, you know, gone on holiday with me, like abroad and everything. So you know, love, much love, and no shame, you know, because some people just are very sentimental, and I'm one of those very sentimental people, and he's been there for me, he's been a good friend, and he will continue to be a good friend, and, you know, that's all you can ask. And the fact that he was a bear based on a property doesn't make a difference. There is a quote in, where is it? There's a quote by Christopher Milne, I think Milne is how you pronounce that last name. Which essentially is, you know, everybody has their Pooh Bear, but your Pooh Bear is your Pooh Bear, and that's what makes him special, and I think that applies here. This this might be an old bear, but he's my old bear, and that's what makes him special. That and the fact that I call him Oldie, even though he's younger than me. He will turn 23 this Christmas. Right. So he's going to remain with us whilst I talk about the other things that I'm going to talk about, because, you know, there's no reason to get rid of him. There's no reason to get rid of him, but I'll put him a little bit out of the way. Alright, so the next thing I want to talk about is Buffy. As in Buffy the Vampire Slayer. But yeah, as if it wasn't obvious. So for me, this is in a similar vein to Charmed. It's something that I'd seen a lot during my teenage years, and then a few years ago absolutely binge watched the hell out of it, and again watched every single episode through, all the way through every single series to the end, and then went back and did the exact same again. And again, I looked up a lot of trivia, and I looked up a lot of, you know, this, that and the other as I was watching each episode, and after I finished watching each episode. So it was something that whilst I was watching it and doing my binge crashing of it, I was, you know, very, very, very passionately obsessed with, I guess would be the A way of putting it. Again, it's one of those things that I liked the characters. I liked the relationship that, you know, were developed, and you know, there are certain episodes and there are still certain episodes that it's not so much that I dislike them, they just make me uncomfortable to watch because of my own fears, I guess, and sensibilities and whatever else. But at the same time, there is still something fun about it, there's something humorous about it, because, you know, it's designed to be both dark and funny at the same time, and yeah, it appeals to me in the same way that Charmed very much appealed to me. And it was definitely a good show, as far as I'm concerned, and I know that's not an unpopular opinion. I know there are some people who would disagree, but I know it's not, it's far from an unpopular opinion. So I'm fairly sure that, you know, most of you will get why I was a big fan of Buffy. And why, again, it's one of those things that, you know, if it's on, I would watch. You know, maybe sometime in the future I might want to binge watch all the episodes all over again. Right now, maybe not so much. But it's definitely one of those things that it's fun, it's enjoyable, it's, for me, it was worth, you know, going back and watching it all, and I have my favourite moments and I have my favourite characters, as everybody does. And you know, it's nice to have something that you can sort of look back on and go, yeah, that was a good thing to be into when I was really into it. Maybe I'm not so into it right now, but yeah. It was good. Because as I said, I don't really want to repeat myself and basically sound like I'm doing the Charmed one again, which I could end up doing. I will move on to the third thing that I want to talk about, which, I mean, I know game theory is one of those things that I need to talk about in one of these at some point, but that's not going to be today. This is my fanfluation video, my fanfluation vlog top. So whenever I do a fanfluation, I'll be wearing this. That doesn't mean I have to talk about anything to do with it. Just know that's why I'm going to be wearing it. The last thing I want to talk about then is Steven Universe. And I know this is a divisive one for people who know about it. Because there are some people who absolutely love it, and there are some people who are very ambivalent towards it, and there are some people who absolutely hate it or dislike the fandom or whatever else. But I want to talk about the reasons why I quite like it and why I got into it to begin with. and why I'm still, you know, excited for new episodes coming out and dip my toe a little bit into the fandom. Not a huge amount. Mostly I tend to watch people talking about their fan theories and their opinions of the episodes and stuff like that, but it's still, you know, my way of experiencing the fandom, even if I'm not fully immersed in the fandom, because you don't need to be fully immersed in every single fandom. That would get very tiring. You need to be as immersed as you want to be, and I think that's very much what I do with Steven Universe. So it was one of these shows that I'd sort of heard twitterings about here and there from certain YouTube channels that I watch. It was on my periphery. So I was like, okay, I will go watch it and see what it was all about. And I started watching the first episode, and I got to the point where Steven's shield emerged for the first time. And obviously it is pink, and it is a defensive weapon, and in my brain, growing up as a child of the 90s and all that, you know, late 80s and 90s TV shows that I grew up with, because that was where, you know, what was there, the trope of the male character who gets something that is considered less than manly, and they have to learn that actually it's a good thing, and that they should, you know, accept themselves for who they are and blah blah blah. I was sick to death, absolutely, of that trope, because I just felt growing up that I'd just seen it too much. And even, you know, even in certain shows that are a bit more recent, it's still there, it's still that sort of underlying thing of, you know, yeah. And then what they did was they just had Steven completely amazed and accepting and no issues whatsoever at all with this pink shield, and at that point I knew this was going to be a completely different show. I mean, I definitely agree with people who sort of say, you know, the very early season isn't necessarily the best, but at the same time, those seeds were there from the beginning that this wasn't going to be the same type of show, the same type of characters as what I grew up with, and, you know, from that point, I was just hooked. And it's really unusual for me to be hooked absolutely from the first episode or something. Usually it'll take, you know, two or three episodes, it'll take me warming up to the character a little bit, especially because, you know, Steven Universe episodes are only like 11 minutes long, they're nothing. It's hardly any time at all to get to know the characters, especially like right at the beginning. But it was just that intrigue of this isn't going to be like everything else that I've watched. Or everything else that I watched, you know, as a kid growing up, that, you know, okay, yeah, they may still have some of those, you know, familiar tropes here and there, but it's presented in a different way. It's not, you know, it's different, and it's good different, and I like the characters, and even the characters that I'm not particularly fond of, I still kind of, you know, it's a more diverse group of characters, and it's more, I don't know, I don't know, but I, as I said, I do know it was that moment in that first episode where my expectations were, you know, this is just going to be like every other, and it wasn't, and that kind of set the tone for everything that was to come after. When I first started watching, they'd only reached like 14 episodes into season 2 at the most. I don't think it was very many at all. So I watched all the way through season 1 up to that point 3 times before any new episodes were released. You know, there's only like 10 minutes. It doesn't take you that long to get through Steven Universe. It really doesn't. Not, you know, at the beginning. Probably at this point now, but not at the beginning. I just rocketed through it and again and again. So that just kind of goes to show that, yeah, okay, there are like a couple of episodes here and there that I really don't like and I probably wouldn't watch again. But for the most part, there is enough there. There is enough there to keep me hooked and to keep me watching, and there is enough there to keep me liking the characters, and there is enough there to keep me knowing that this isn't going to, you know, fall into all the old familiar tropes of kids shows when I was growing up. And as I said, yes, some of it is there, but it's done in a different way. It's not presented in the same way, and it's much more mature show, I think, than a lot of the things that I grew up with, in, you know, in a different way. It's mature in a different way. So it's one of those things that I very much look forward to seeing where it's going, and I have my own theories and my own thoughts about how I'd like things to go and where I think things might be going. And you know, certain episodes recently, with certain events which have happened, and I won't go more specific than that, but I did, I had this absolute moment where it's kind of like, yeah, that's how I would have written it if I was in control. that is something straight out of one of my plot lines. So I think, you know, it's one of those things that I do have a great deal of love and a great deal of passion for, and I wish I had people around me that I can talk to about it, an actual human person and not like just online, because sometimes it's nice to be excitable and fangirling with somebody who is with you rather than, you know, somebody you can't see. And at the moment, I don't really have that, and I want that. I want someone to be fangirly with. One day. Alright. So I think I've said just about everything that I need to say in this fabulation video. I can't really think of much more that needs to be sort of said. So the next vlog, I think we won't jump straight back into the multiverse because we didn't last time. I think the next vlog will be focused on a very writerly thing. And that will be character perspectives and how I like to use character perspectives, and whether I'm writing in first person or third person, or whether I'm writing prose or script or, you know, whatever else. I think it'll be, you know, a good nitty gritty episode. Episode vlog. It'll be a good nitty gritty vlog, for whatever that means. Alright. So I hope you've enjoyed this one. I hope you've learned a little bit more about me and the fact that I am a complete matter and the same person. My lips fell out, my favourite thing. Because why wouldn't I? Anyway, I hope to see you all again next time. So from him, see ya, and from me, see ya. Ha ha.